Let's talk about kinematics. In particular, we're going to talk about kinematics and the motion that fluid elements can undergo. And we're going to look at this in a differential fashion. So the first type of movement that a fluid element can undergo is the easiest. This is what's known as translation. And if you notice, it keeps its shape as it translates. The second is what's known as linear deformation. So you start with a fluid particle and it increases or decreases its volume. And we measure this by the volume dilatation rate. I did not spell that right. And one thing that you have to keep in mind is that for an incompressible fluid, it cannot undergo volume dilatation because the volume changes when the mass doesn't. We can also have rotation, so that fluid particle rotates. And finally, we have what's known as angular deformation. So how do we analyze these processes? Well, the first one that I'll talk about is linear deformation, and we can calculate that as the change in u with respect to x plus the change in v with respect to y plus the change in w with respect to z. And that makes sense because the volume is changing in the direction, the same direction as the velocity. The next thing we'll look at is rotation. So you can rotate along any of the three axes. So for example, around the z-axis, it's 1/2 dv dx minus du dy. If it's around the x-axis, it's 1/2 dw dy minus dv dz. And finally, if it's around the y-axis, it's 1/2 du dz minus dw dx. We often, instead of talking about rotation, we talk about vorticity, which is twice the rotation. And the reason for that is to get rid of the 1/2. The final type of movement is what's known as angular deformation. And angular deformation can be calculated as dv dx plus du dy. So if, for example, our linear deformation equals zero, then the fluid is incompressible. And if our rotation equals zero, then the fluid is what's known as irrotational.